Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, our distinguished guests, dear friends. I would like to welcome you all and thank you very much for coming to this wonderful place called the Peace Garden. The name of the location, I would say, is very appropriate for our event because I think you would all agree peace is in the essence of what brings us here this afternoon. I would like just to start with a brief background about Israel. The Oneness Home, Sri Chinmoy Oneness Home Israel, is a global torch relay which symbolizes humanity's universal yearning for more peaceful and harmonious world. From country to country, as the torch is passed from hand to hand, Israel unites people, creating a global wave of friendship, understanding, and oneness. Its participants, ranging from children to senior citizens, from everyday folks to world leaders, from people from different backgrounds and cultural heritage, all join and share their dreams and hopes for peace. Israel does not raise money or highlight any political cause. It simply strives to create a goodwill between peoples of all nations. It invites everyone to take a step towards a better world. So it started in 1987 when the founder of Israel, Sri Chinmoy, had a vision of this global manifestation that would spread the message of peace throughout the whole world. Since then, Israel has visited over 140 countries, countless towns, cities, communities, and touched the lives of millions of people. The founder, Sri Chinmoy, has dedicated his entire life to serving world community through his peace efforts. Just to mention a few of them, Sri Chinmoy conducted peace meditations twice weekly at the United Nations for delegates and staff members and NGO representatives. Also, he offered several hundreds of lectures at universities and peace concerts all over the world, and used sports as a powerful vehicle to promote peace and the unlimited potential of human spirit. Sri Chinmoy was also a composer. He composed many songs about peace. Right now we are going to hear the song that he composed specifically for the Peace Ramp, and followed by another song about peace. Before the singers come up, I would just like to share with you a quote by Sri Chinmoy. "Today's chaotic world cannot forever remain chaotic. World harmony, world peace, these are not mere dictionary words. These are the realities, divine, supreme realities." Here's another quote by Sri Chinmoy that I would like to share with you. He said, "There shall come a time when this world of ours will be flooded with peace. Who is going to bring about this radical change? It will be you. Sisters and brothers, it will be you and your oneness hearts which are spread throughout the length and breadth of the world." Through the Sri Chinmoy Oneness Home Peace Run, invariably we meet people of service who have dedicated their lives towards improving the lives of others, towards improving their communities, towards improving the world. This award has been presented to people from various walks of life. For example, great humanitarians such as Archbishop Desmond Tutu, extraordinary athletes such as Carl Lewis, heads of state such as prime ministers of East Timor, heads of municipalities such as Mayor of Ottawa, Jim Watson. Today we are very happy and honored that we have here with us one very deserving recipient. And I would like to invite Pushparani to introduce this remarkable person.
I'd like to say a few words about Dr. Jamal Al-Sharif. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Dr. Jamal is being honored today for his extraordinary service and volunteerism initiative in our community and beyond. Someone that Sri Chinmoy would describe as a selfless server. Someone who enriches our community and brings people together. One of the ways Dr. Jamal achieves this goal is through his Humans for Peace Institute, a nonprofit organization that he founded in 2015 after being in Canada only a short while himself. He and his colleagues here today organized several humanitarian services and projects, such as youth groups, food drives, blood drives, fundraisers for cancer patients, giving to children in poverty, lectures, and help for the newcomers. Syrians for Peace, the Clean the 30 Streets in 30 Days project, Haircuts for Kindness, the delivery of school supplies to children in Madagascar, and many other projects which create understanding between people of different backgrounds. Dr. Jamal and his Humans for Peace colleagues are shining examples of self-offering and inclusiveness that we all can follow. The following quote I've taken from Dr. Jamal that I believe sums up his message and his life. No matter what color your skin is, no matter what language you speak, no matter what religion you believe in, if you call this earth your home, we call you family. At a time when you can feel that there is oftentimes more division in the world than love and oneness, we desperately need the heroic efforts of individuals such as Dr. Jamal Al-Sharif and his Humans for Peace colleagues. And we would urge you to continue and continue and continue your work. I'd now like to invite up Dr. Jamal Al-Sharif to receive the Sri Chinmoy Oneness Home Peace Run Torchbearer.
I did prepare a speech today, but I don't want to read something. I want to speak from my heart. Thank you first for Peace Run organization. It's incredible what you are doing. Is something we all need, because on this earth we don't have time to wait for somebody to do something for us. We have to go the extra mile, and people like you, like Humans for Peace, we're ready to do that extra mile. I couldn't do anything without Human for Peace Institution and people behind it. We have a small example over here from my family. It's not only my wife and my son, but my brothers and sister who started with me Human for Peace, who believed in this message. But today, I would like to give this to a friend of mine, all of us, a sister. We lost her 2 days ago. She died peacefully, but she believed in this extra mile. She'd been there for everybody of us. She cared about every one of us. Yasmin, you left us, but you will stay in our heart. The last message she sent to our family was asking about my wife's family back in China. She cared about my son. She was on a hunt for him. Everybody knew Yasmin. Only remember her smile, her compassion, her love. She never said no for a good cause. So without you, Yasmin, we will continue your message, but we pray that Almighty God will give you a better place in heaven, because you always open your heart, your house, and you make it a paradise for everybody visited. So please help me and stand for a second moment of silence for her soul. Thank you. I'm really sorry, but as I said, it's from the heart. And we know, Yasmin, you hear us today. This is for you, Yasmin. Thank you.
Jamal. He's a person that speaks from his heart, who likes to chat with everyone, and has a very open-hearted person, very generous, gives out his time, and with an amazing broad smile. It's not just the tears, it's the smile too, that gives his charm. I think it's well deserved. Yasmin would be here photographing right now. She was here. God bless her soul. And a little bit about the generosity of Humans for Peace Institution, which was founded by Dr. Jamal. And so it's based, as he said, on peace and love and giving out time. It's totally volunteer based. So basically, if you have that time, why not be generous with it? For a good reason, of course. And Humans for Peace, it's rather something that, it's an institution that believes that no matter what you believe in, no matter what your color, what your cultural background, where you come from, you're more than welcome to be part of this family. So our derivatives that have been done, or the things that we have been
that have been accomplished during the past 2-3 years are the Children's for Peace, some youth-driven initiatives. We've had a blood donation initiative, Syrians and newcomers giving back to community for all the generosity of Canadians and how they were embraced by Canada as a new home. It was the Children's for Peace with the music and dealing with PTSD for that. So it's mainly believing in peace. That's all what we think that you we can all live together if we live in peace. So I think both organizations, if it's your organization, if it's the institution, they both mend together in the belief in peace. One of our upcoming initiatives, which I would like to invite you all to maybe take part of it, is Let's Beat Cancer, which is upcoming on the 28th of March. So the initiative is to fundraise basically for cancer patients and giving them hope. All the proceedings will be going to painting of Canadian like the cancer patients' homes, even the residents maybe of patients. So please, if you're interested, come join us and be part of the family. Thank you very much.
For all that you're doing, you are really an example that people should follow. As you were saying, we speak from the heart, and that's what we do also. We speak from our hearts. And we are sincerely grateful for what you are doing. And as a small token of our appreciation, Sri Chinmoy was an artist, and this painting is very appropriate for you. Universal Brotherhood. So this represents what your heart feels, I hope, and we hope that you'll look at it from time to time and get there.
Can I invite all the Human for Peace members?
Yes,
to be
we'd
here.
Like everybody to come up and
maybe
have a picture.
Because it's not mine. Or
yes, I know.
Get it in pieces.
Yes, all of you people are
come
part
here,
of us, and we're all a big fan. So you can come out here. You want to come?
I will recite.
I will stay.
Mama, you need to.
It's a
rhyme.
What's true? It's a rhyme.
What is that?
Response to life's every challenge.
Okay.